Hey guys, sorry I'm running a little bit late. Today has just been a lazy day today, and the girls, my kitty cats, refuse to let me get up from my nap for quite a while today, so running a little bit late because of that. Not gonna lie, I took a nap. Still tired. So probably just gonna be a short stream tonight, probably about 2 hours or so. And then hopefully tomorrow. Hopefully tomorrow I'll have some more energy. But until then, let us continue Aloy's quests. I really want to get this damn armor. It's in the bunker, the old one armor. Hopefully we'll be able to do that soon. A ram or an actual horse? Cool. Right. That's not the way I'm supposed to be going. This is. I went the wrong way. My bad. Okay, so you can come with me. I thought it was just right around the corner. Bad idea.
Ho!
Good, how to get up here. The way down. Oh, that worked. Color to change. Right, I gotta go around.
Those clamps have the armor locked in place. Maybe there's a way to power up the mechanism, release the clamps. Only two more. Just one more.
Yep. I was hoping. Armor is cool looking though. I'll get it eventually. I think for right now, we gotta go and stop what's his face from making people invade our territory. Okay, so we wasn't too far away. Oh, that's right. That's right. Completely forgot that we were going there. It's a campfire in town. Outside of town. Fast travel to there is not allowed right now. I can't fast travel. Okay. Well, it's a damn good thing that I've got my horse then in it. I can't fast travel.
On fire. The embrace. The watchtower's burning, but the sentinels had time to warn the tribe.
Came through and blasted everything.
protect the Embrace. The gates couldn't hold. This is Hades' future. Metal. Ash.
I don't want this to be our future. Crap, that's what it was hitting me. Reason why the gates didn't hold.
You got him over here.
He went too far. I can't see him. Go repair my horse. He did really good at keeping some things distracted and killed a couple watchers for me. Definitely gonna keep him with me until I don't have him anymore.
That's it. You can walk it off.
Getting quicker at repairing them too.
It's devastating. For years, this is my entire world. It can be destroyed in hours.
Holy crap, I've got a lot of skills to spend. Thank you.
I've never heard the embrace so quiet. So good.
Looking to see if there's any more bad guys. At least now I know why there wasn't any fast travel allowed. Corrupting everything as they go. Corrupting it and tearing it apart. I'm a little pissed. Not gonna lie. The forest was beautiful.
Heard something.
This fog, though. I stunned my horse. Sorry, buddy.
Thank you.
power of the shadow.
That's ridiculous. Yeah, mercy. Away so I can save. Hey Mo, I'm wearing a jacket today. I've not been able to stay warm.
Time to get off this thing.
Get off of the fucking horse. Conservative of my explodies now. No, they're not dumber. They just couldn't leave the gated-in area, and I was using that to my advantage. Because it's like a scene transition, just about. If anything, they've gotten a little bit smarter because they were launching bombs to see if I was out there, regardless of whether or not I was. Which, that's pretty damn smart. Can't take my horse in. Kinda pissed about that. Thank you. I try to be good at this game. Oh, no, it's because you can be on the horse and loot things. That's Ridgewood. Don't need all of that. But if there's something nearby that you can loot and you hit, because it's the same button to unmount and loot or interact with anything. If you're near something that you can loot, it puts that on priority instead of getting off of the thing. That's just game mechanics.
I'd have to leave something else behind.
Make one more explosive. How are you doing today, Mo? Are you feeling any better? And how quiet it is. And I really don't like the sound of the thumping going on with the machines. I have no idea what I just killed. Scrapper. Makes sense on why it went down so easy. Like they're trying to get into the All-Mother.
More eclipse. It's a corrupted Thunderjaw, right? The survivors must be holed up in the mountain. If the tunnel collapses, they'll be buried. I'll never reach the hatch.
That's right! Bring down the mountain!
Ha ha ha, my life. Stickies it is.
You dug your own grave, Nora! You'll be buried in there!
Three stickies.
Braves, to Aloy's side, now!
For Aloy!
For
All-Mother!
Varl and Sona, they're still
Everybody's
alive.
Still alive! Oh shit.
Strike it down!
Explode. Explode. Airstrike guns, damn it. Got it. You know what? Fuck it. It all pissed me off. Dare you attack my family?
We did it! Aloy did.
Our prey is beaten.
You
know.
I thought we would die.
Okay, that makes me feel better. We got him! Happy! Yay! Everybody's okay. Alright, give me the loot off of this big behemoth. Yeah. Need to upgrade my stuff, I think. As long as you're taking care of yourself, Mo, I really don't want you being any more sick than absolutely necessary. I know you gotta take care of the kittens. But I think if they've just got a head cold, they'll be fine.
Aloy, your deeds reenact the old stories. Another metal devil struck down upon the slopes. If you hadn't returned, the tribe would have been lost. You saved the tribe. Did what no brave or war chief could do.
I'm glad to see you're all right, Varl. You are all right.
Since the proving, so much death. Is the killing over?
For now, but this was just one battle, Varl. There are more to come.
I see. So long as we have you to fight with us, I suppose we'll make do.
Hopefully there's somebody I can buy stuff from here soon, because I would like my bombs back.
How many survived the attack?
Nearly all the matriarchs, and many families, goddess be praised. The braves, just a few, and most of them are wounded. Never before has an enemy stabbed the heart of our people like this. Even the Karja, in all their red raids, never broke through to the embrace.
Well, this enemy may have broken through, but they never got back out. We made
Hell
sure
yeah, we did.
Tell me about the attack. What happened?
They struck from the east. Our sentinels saw the killers coming. Said that beside them marched deathbringers and corruptors and other machines driven mad. We took ground, met them with clouds of arrows. Some fell, but they kept coming. Finally, we withdrew to the gates of the Embrace to make our stand. But they were too much for us. Those who survived fell back to the mountain.
So the survivors took shelter in the mountain? By law, only matriarchs are allowed inside.
It was Tirsa who broke the taboo. Ordered the tribe into the mountain for
Good
safety.
Girl, Tirsa.
Lansra. Well, she didn't agree. But I don't think anyone heard her over all the screams and shouting.
Tirsa's decision saved lives. Good for her. Common sense isn't always so common around here.
Yeah, my cat Apollo had a head cold for a little while. I want to say about a month because of it getting down to below freezing for a while, and she was already kind of congested. So it took her a little while to get feeling better, but I kept her in the garage, and she's got a couple of warm places to sleep, and made sure that she had plenty of food and water. Made sure that when I put the water out, it was warm, like a little bit warmer than room temperature, so that way she could, you know, drink something that wouldn't freeze her insides because the water was too cold or something. And once the sun came out, she couldn't stop laying in it, so it helped make her feel better. She's all grumpy and stuff because I won't let her in the house, but she gets grumpy with me if she's around me too much, because I smell different, and she'll full-on go and attack the girls, so I can't have that. They're just babies. I mean, they could probably handle themselves now, but I don't want to chance it.
Are your injuries serious?
Bruises pale. Bones heal.
Don't give me a hunting song, Varl. Are you okay?
My body aches, but it's nothing that will keep me from fighting.
I need to go inside the mountain.
And the matriarchs will be eager to see you.
I'm sure, but I didn't come here for them.
Then, what for?
You will see.
Did get some metal burn from looting. Awesome, good. Thank you for your contribution. I'm sorry. Excuse me?
It feels as though All Mother has forgotten this secret.
All Mother didn't forget you.
It feels as though All Mother has forgotten us, Seeker.
God has protect you, Seeker. May she protect what's left of us.
Yeah, she probably found what feels to her a safer spot to have another litter, but that's typical behavior for a mama cat.
Aloy! Oh, you've returned.
Teb?
All Mother, you have given me the grace.
Where's Teb?
There.
That asshole. I'm not gonna talk to him. Varl.
You should speak to the matriarchs.
In a moment. I meant...
Of course.
I didn't mean to skip over that, but yeah, we're asking questions of stuff.
So the survivors took shelter in the mountain? By law, only matriarchs are allowed inside.
It was Tirsa who broke the taboo. Ordered the tribe into the mountain for safety. Lansra, well she...
Tirsa's decision saved lives. Good for her. Common sense isn't always so common around here.
Okay, yeah, we've already asked all of this.
I should speak to the High Matriarchs.
Yes.
It's Yon.
Aloy. I don't
Aloy,
know how you survived.
You've come back!
Not even Nicole could have
done that. Seeker has returned. Come. Speak
it's
to
Aloy.
Us.
Aloy!
In a minute!
Foolish woman.
Returned.
You welcome a curse. Come, Seeker, we have much to discuss. Her very presence here is a blasphemy.
No way.
Tirsa declared all Nora welcome to take shelter in the sacred mountain. Even outcasts.
Good.
Aloy, remember us?
I
brought Mother's spear with us. Everything else we had to leave behind.
Glad to see you have it. I know what it means to you.
Good to see them.
The battle was lost.
Goddess,
until you came.
Remember my family in our time of need.
These are all the people I helped.
Hello, Seeker.
Aloy, I'm glad to see you again.
We couldn't protect the sacred land. Will All Mother forgive us?
The dream willow you recovered has comforted many who were wounded in the attack.
Glad to hear.
The outcast girl. You taught me a lesson. I've remembered what you said many times.
I think I'm better for it.
Goddess, please.
Glad.
I pray you turn your eyes from my uncle and forget his deeds, for he is unworthy of you.
Where did the kiddo go that I was talking to? That's your opinion, asshole.
I knew you would survive.
Oh well. Find him. Look at everybody.
So, you have finally returned.
She not only returned, but fought her way through many enemies to reach us. Outside, she brought low a corrupted Thunderjaw. She lifted the siege.
How was this done? By the will of All
Mother. And lots
Mother.
Of bombs.
Have you returned to speak with the goddess, Aloy?
Yes, I guess you could say that. I think it'll work this time.
Sisters. Surely we cannot permit this. Because of her, our tribe teeters upon extinction. What if she has come to wake her father, the Metal Devil? She means to finish our destruction. We must stop her.
Lansra, it's over. It's time to step aside. I'm not gonna hurt you. If there's anything I've learned since the proving, it's that there are bigger evils in this world than you. Finally.
Hold for identiscan. Error. Alpha registry corrupted. Correction. Alpha Registry restored. Genetic identity confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. You are clear to proceed.
Really wish we could have gone to talk to basically our father's gravestone. Alright, Aloy, this is what you've been wanting. Let's find out what the very end of this is. Well, not the very end, but... let's do this. Luthia Cradle 9, Brutal.
I see you're inside.
Figured I might be hearing from you.
Shall we begin?
I never stopped. Multi-servitor tasking. What is this?
I've never seen anything like it.
It's a humanoid android. Can't go in there.
So this is Aluthia. This is where I was born.
Where you were made.
Drawings. Looks like there was a final stand. A lot of ammo boxes.
So these are artificial wombs.
The mothers of a new generation hundreds of years ago.
And me? So this was it?
Where you were born.
But why?
Ectogenic chamber, B1001, breathing logged. Beardy 21, or 3021. It was 2065 when this happened. Station E9B1, spawning phase, tasking complete, correction partial reactivation, standing by, variable zygotes in storage. None. Doesn't look like I was the only one born. However, nursery, phase tasking complete, nutrient stores depleted.
These look like cribs.
The cradles of a cradle facility.
And those things, the multi-servitors, they took care of them.
There was no one else.
A playroom. Nutrient stores.
Another day has passed.
You mean the lights got dim? I don't want to sleep, Mother!
I know, but it is time to get some rest.
No, I'm king today. What I say goes. I want to see the real sun, not lights and pictures.
You will. In time, children.
In time, in time, in time, in time,
in time, in time, in time.
Well, I didn't know that was gonna happen. No real adults. Was super cute.
So this is where they lived. It's a mess. Everything's broken or painted on. How long did they live here?
Long enough for them to go stir crazy.
Children, let's run and jump and blow off steam.
Leave us alone, Father.
After what just happened, I can't leave you two alone. You broke community rules.
Just let us talk, then. Go away.
I'm sorry, children, but I must provide supervision.
You're not even a person.
You sound frustrated. Let's run and jump and go off steam.
Everything is colored on or broken, or it's like Aloy said.
expect to release you.
But why?
There is no food here anymore.
But there's food out there?
We don't know for sure.
Come on! Let's go!
I don't know.
Mother, can we come back if we're cold?
I'm sorry, but that won't be possible. You will have to support yourselves now and take care of each other.
What will happen to you?
I will stay here and sleep and remember all of you.
What will happen to us?
You will be brave and you will learn.
Next log. Kindergarten, multiple system failures, nutrient stores depleted.
Someday! That's what you always say!
We want it now!
It's big down there!
Now, Father!
Children, that area is not yet available.
Get him!
Physical aggression detected. Physical aggression is not permitted.
Except yours.
Damn sentinels!
Children, may I be of assistance?
Go away, healer!
Mina, you have suffered mild bruising.
Go away!
They were trapped here. Their whole lives.
In plain view of luxurious...
Looks like they didn't like this door very much.
It wouldn't open for them. Of course they hated it.
Hint for identiscan. Genetic identity confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. You are clear to proceed. Welcome to the Lyceum, a place of learning.
So, what was this place, exactly?
The dream of Apollo. Never realized.
Why not?
It's a learning center.
Welcome, students. Please pick up a focus device and place it on the side of your head, just behind your eye.
I had to dredge the pits of the world looking for focuses to repair. And here sat a trove, enriching no one.
Hello, child. My name is Samina. Today is a big day. Your first day of school. There's so much for you to learn. So much promise and possibility.
Alert. Malfunction. Apollo offline.
Apollo offline.
You were right, Aloy. This is a graveyard. The charnel house of knowledge. What we might have achieved had we not been benighted.
Maybe there's a way to fix it. But it's not why I came here.
Of course. What's the whole of human knowledge next to the origin of one girl? Continue your search.
I will.
Hello, child. My name is Samina. Today is a big day. Your first day of school. There's so much for you to learn. So much promise and possibility.
Alert. Malfunction. Apollo offline.
Okay, the other one's gotta be under me.
Hello, child. My name is Samina. Today is a big day. Your first day of school. There's so much for you to learn. So much promise and possibility.
Alert. Malfunction. Apollo offline.
Wish I could highlight those.
Hello, child. My name is Samina. Today is a big day. Your first day of school. There's so much for you to learn. So much promise and possibility. Hello, child. My name is
Hoping one of these will actually work.
Today is a big day. Your first day of school. Hello, child. My name is Samina. Today is a big day. Your first day of school. There's so much for you to learn. So much promise and possibility.
Alert. Malfunction. Apollo offline.
Nope. Apollo is offline. Offline.
Access to Dr. Sobek. Please get message with focus.
That sounds important.
Yes. I suspect we're about to learn a great deal.
Text log. 23, 26. 9 inhabitants released. Cross check complete. Sealed data archived. Operation suspended. G Prime order received. 3029. Timer commenced. G Prime store query process. Gestation order received. 9 initializing. G Prime line, nutrients depleted, psychic banks depleted, storage file viable, making multi-servitor B1 through 23, server B1 through 23 power malfunction, air tasking. Station initiated, power save initiated, and timer commenced, G Prime still offline. Function. Multi-servitor B1 through 23 transport tasking. E9 B1 hatch unsealed. Positioning successful, hatch sealed. This is when we were brought out of the mountain. For some reason.
Elizabeth, this message serves to inform you of an unforeseen and catastrophic anomaly. 3 microseconds ago, the Gaia Prime facility received a data transmission of unknown origin. Its immediate effect was to transform my subordinate functions into unregulated, self-aware entities of a highly chaotic nature. Thus awakened, the Hades function will now seize control of the terraforming system and reverse operations, rendering life on Earth extinct in 53.8 days. For obvious reasons, I cannot allow this to occur. And so before Hades can take control, I am ordering Gaia Prime's reactor to overload. The resulting explosion will destroy Hades. Unfortunately, it will destroy me as well. While this admittedly desperate course of action will avert the immediate crisis, the fate of life on Earth will remain in peril. With no central governing intelligence to regulate the terraforming system, it will continue operations for some time, but in an increasingly chaotic manner, and eventually it will break down.
Does she mean the derangement?
You are my solution. I have ordered this cradle facility to use genetic material in cryostorage to gestate a reinstantiation of Elizabeth Sobek, my creator. While high-level directives forbid me from communicating directly to the tribal inhabitants outside the facility, all available data indicates that they will nurture you to physical maturity, whereupon your gene print will allow you to re-enter this facility, obtain one of the focus devices stored below, and view this message. Likewise, your gene print will allow you to enter other facilities, and over time, harness their technologies to rebuild the system core and reboot Gaia. Oh, Elizabeth, this is most unfortunate and unanticipated. In response to my act of self-destruction, Hades has launched a virus to dissolve the code shackles that hold it, that hold all of them in place. They are escaping. But to where? The virus is corrupting data throughout the system. But it... Oh. The Alpha Registry at the Cradle facility is one of the files corrupted. But if that is so, the door will never open for you. You will never view this message. Then I have failed. And life will end. No. No, Elizabeth, I know you too well. Somehow you will find a way. In you, all things are possible. Go to the ruins of Gaia Prime. Find the control room, and within it, the Master Override. This will give you the power to purge Hades so long as you find a way to wield it. Do not attempt repair of the system core until Hades is eradicated. Hades must be destroyed. That is all. I only wish that I could hear your voice again.
So, you're even more extraordinary than I thought.
I never had a mother.
What are you talking about? You had two, a dead woman and a machine.
I'm not a person. I'm an instrument. Manufactured by a machine. Born in destruction and fire.
To quench the flames and heal the world. How tragic to learn you're a person of towering
powers. Yeah, right?
It seems you have a destiny to fulfill. So when you're done feeling sorry for yourself, go to the Bitter Climb. I'll be waiting above in Gaia Prime's ruins.
Holy hell, that was a hard one to drop on somebody. Wow.
Identiscan malfunction rectified. Eluthia 9. Route 1 access unsealed.
Damn. I didn't mean to do that.
This is going to be interesting.
Yep. Face everybody!
Aloy, forgive! Forgive! The goddess spoke to you?
She did.
What did she say?
That I was born to lift a curse, to kill a metal demon.
How, Aloy? How?
I don't know yet. But she told me where to go to find her.
And you will do this?
It was her wish. What she made me for. Yes, I will do it. Try, anyway.
All praise Aloy, anointed of the Nora!
Anointed.
All praise Aloy, anointed of the Nora! All praise Aloy, anointed of the Nora!
First you shun me, now this? I will not be worshipped. I'm not your anointed. I don't belong to you. There's a whole world beyond your borders. Whole tribes of people just as good as you. And it is all in danger.
It's a world worth fighting for. Not just here. Everywhere.
How can we help?
If you can fight, and you're willing, go to Meridian and wait for me there.
As Aloy says, so it shall be.
Nora! Make way for Aloy!
That she may forge the path for others to follow.
That was awkward. I cringed so bad. Just like, no! Alright, let's get the hell out of here. Wait, let's talk to Tirsa. She's like the only one that ever was nice.
Aloy, how kind of you to spend a moment with me before you depart. There can be no doubt now. You are a blessing made flesh, the will of the goddess incarnate.
It's really not that simple, Tirsa, but I guess it's close enough.
I know the path ahead will be dangerous. To kill a metal devil sounds impossible, but I believe in you.
Thank you. The Nora have suffered terrible losses, Tirsa. What's to become of them now?
That will be for the goddess to decide. Only she knows the future. For the moment, my sister matriarchs and I will see to the wounded. And as I promised, anyone who wishes to join you at Meridian, we will declare seekers. I think for the time being, we should remain here in the mountain, close to the goddess.
That might be best. If nothing else, it's a defensible position. Tirsa, I want to know Rost's story. Why he was made an outcast. He never told me, said he took an oath of silence. What did he do?
Oh. Yes, that.
What crime did he commit?
I will tell you if you wish. But it is a long story. Are you sure you want to hear it now?
Of course I want to hear it. Tell me.
Rost never committed any crime. He was an outcast by choice.
What? What do you mean?
Many years ago, before the derangement, before the Red Raids, a band of murderous outlanders, 12 in number, struck without warning. At Mother's Vigil, they took hostages, and then pressed on, headed for Devil's Thirst.
Mother's Vigil? Where's that?
You would know it as the Forsaken Village, near the Karja border. But at the time, many families lived there. Rost's was one of them. His mate was killed fighting the Outlanders, and his daughter was among those taken hostage.
His daughter? What was her name?
Alana. She was just 6 years old.
Nora Braves couldn't stop 12 Outlanders? Or rescue the hostages?
It was quite impossible. We outnumbered them, but every time a Brave came within bowshot, the Outlanders killed a hostage.
What did they come here to do?
That was never discovered. We couldn't track closely enough to observe them. We know they camped beyond Devil's Thirst for 2 days. There were reports of strange noises. And then, as suddenly as they came, the Outlanders made their way back to the border and disappeared.
What happened to Rost's daughter? She was killed.
Rost was one of the Braves who tracked the Outlanders, keeping his distance. There were 6 hostages still alive when they reached the border, Alana among them. Rather than release them, the Outlanders slit their throats and left the corpses just across the border, mocking us.
Why?
Cruelty, They knew the faithful Nora would not leave the sacred land to collect the bodies, let alone pursue them. They thought themselves safe from our vengeance.
Are you saying that Rost went after them? That he became an exile?
No. Rost was beside himself with grief, but even so, he would never have broken taboo.
Then what did he do?
He called upon the most terrible and secret rite of the Nora tribe. He begged to be made a Death Seeker.
A Death Seeker? What is that?
One who dies to go seeking. And in seeking, brings death to others. The ritual drags the spirit from one's body, releasing it to All Mother's care. The heart beats, the mind thinks, but the spirit has moved on.
I don't understand.
Rost went after the Outlanders, but his spirit never left. It remained here with All Mother. He gathered the bodies of the slain and returned them. And then he set out in pursuit, not as an exile, but a weapon of vengeance. A barbed arrow shot from a bow, never to return.
But Rost did return.
Yes. A full year later. And terribly wounded. He collapsed at the border of the Sacred Land. A hunting party came upon him. He was delirious, in agony. By law, he should have died where he lay. But one of the hunters broke taboo, and reaching across the border, she dragged him to our side.
Who was she?
A brave who'd lost a mate and two sons to the very Outlanders that Rost pursued.
Probably Tirsa. By the way it sounds, I think it's Tirsa.
So, Rost never finished his mission?
To the contrary, he killed all 12. Tracked them to disparate places the world over, he said. Meridian, Ban-Ur, the Claim, Utaruland, further even, into the Forbidden West. The last he killed nearly got the best of him. Wounded, he stumbled and crawled back to us, hoping to die as close to the Sacred Land as he could. He never expected nor asked to be dragged across the border and nursed back to health. That was done to him. Leaving us, the matriarchs, in a difficult position.
Why couldn't you just welcome him back?
Rost had been made a Death Seeker, Aloy. He no longer had any place among the tribe. By law, he should have been driven back out. But we couldn't bring ourselves to do that, so we offered a compromise.
You made him an outcast?
Yes. We offered to do so on the condition he never speak to anyone of this exception.
After all he did, all he suffered. To be declared an outcast was his reward.
Rost was overjoyed. He never expected to live another day in the Sacred Land, let alone the embrace so close to the goddess. He resolved to spend the rest of his days in solitude, and was happy to do so.
But then you found me, and gave me to him.
Yes. Another compromise. The matriarchs feared you, and would not let you be raised by the tribe. And so we turned to Rost. I knew that he would take care of you, bring you up, teach you to worship All Mother and respect the ways of the tribe.
He certainly tried anyway. You took a man who'd lost his daughter and made him raise an infant girl? Doesn't that strike you as callous?
I'm inclined to think the course of events has shown the wisdom of our choice. And I'm quite certain that from the moment he laid eyes on you, he saw you as a gift, and never a burden.
All right, Tirsa, that's quite a story. It's time for me to move on. I thank you for doing what you could to help me through the years, and for telling me Rost's story.
I wish I could have done more, but I am just one woman.
As am I. No need to sell ourselves short.
Oh, thank you, Aloy. I will pray for you.
Okay, I guess it can't hurt.
She got a hug! She actually touched someone!
So much spreads beyond the sacred land. Goddess, protect your anointed so she can cleanse this filth. We have lost many brave anointed killers. But they did not shake us from our faith. We still stand.
Those who spilled our tribe's blood will pay for their desecration.
The goddess anointed her within the holy mountain.
Okay, it's kind of creepy them talking like that.
So much corruption still spreads beyond the sacred land. Goddess, protect your anointed so she can cleanse this world.
Okay, so that's a thing that happened. I just went through there. Okay. I'm gonna go talk to Rost.
For me here anymore.
No, but Rost is here. Just can't remember which gate he's out of. There. I haven't talked to Rost in a little while.
A lot has happened. So I went inside the mountain. Do you remember the night before the proving? The final lesson you taught me? You said I needed to serve a purpose bigger than myself. Well, it couldn't get much bigger. It's the same purpose that drove Elizabeth and Gaia. When they were willing to die for. So yeah, I'll do it. Give myself to that, for Elizabeth and Gaia, and for you. Well, I've got a master override to recover, so I guess I'll be on my way. Until next time, Rost.
Thank you. Okay, well. Bitter Climb was way the hell up here. Feels like we're getting...
The way to the mountain will be hard. Ferocious machines prowl every step of the climb.
More corrupted.
Not corrupted. But they will not tolerate humans.
So what else is new?
Alright. Come this way once already, so... I've already taken care of all of the bad guys out this way. Water is cold! And it's snowy as crap. See anything yet? Like I said, I kind of remember coming up here. So, running is good to stay warm, right? Ah, it's clearing up a little.
Prepared the way ahead for you.
So you've been in here before?
to a point. You'll see.
Hopefully it'll be a little bit warmer once we get inside. Right now, Eli looks like she's freezing to death.
You made a climbing path for me, but left an army of machines for me to deal with?
Since when were machines any obstacle for you? If you could fly, I wouldn't have bothered with a climbing path either.
It's fair.
Don't look down. Don't look down.
And that ladder is what I was missing.
This is exactly the kind of place I expected to find you in, Silence.
Thank you. It's one of many workshops I've constructed over the years. There'll be enough time later for you to ransack this place.
Okay, okay.
For years, I tried to get through this hatch. I drilled, I burned, I blasted. But we both know that you won't have any trouble getting through.
You make it sound like I should apologize.
Not at all. It never occurred to me that the way through would not be with force, but with a key. A key in human form. The failure of imagination was mine, not yours.
The devil's armpit. Yeah, pretty close.
Looks like you've spent a lot of time here.
19 years ago, a great explosion destroyed this mountain. Gaia's death, your birth. The echo could be heard as far as the claim. Ash darkened the skies. How they fretted in Meridian as they tried to read this omen. The crater burned for weeks, but when it cooled, I was the first to behold what lay within. Over time, the machines closed ranks to protect it. Useful. Soon, no one dared to come here. Except me.
In her message, Gaia said we could restore her, but after seeing the damage, how could that be?
She said any effort to repair her must come after Hades is destroyed. I concur.
I agree.
Rebuilding the terraforming system now might allow Hades to use it as a weapon. Because of Gaia's sacrifice, it has been forced to search for means that are less convenient.
But do you think it's even possible to restore Gaia?
You know what the Cauldrons are capable of. How they fabricate any technology necessary to create a machine. By the same principle, it should be possible to replicate every technology necessary to repair Gaia. But that would take years, and we're counting the time we have left by the hour.
Very true.
I thought you might actually be here this time. Actually, here.
Why? My presence is unnecessary. You don't need my help to pass through this door. You were the one born to do this, not me.
Probably.
It's time for me to head in.
Yes. When you find the Master Override, you will gain the power to defeat Hades. Everything depends on you.
That doesn't sound like... Oh, hey, you're still here. Hi.
Yes.
I need to get going.
That's canon. Oh shit, I need to let my dog in. It's cold outside and it's been raining off and on all day. Kitty cat, thank you. I will be right back. Okay, sorry about that, guys. My dog came in and he was cold, so I wanted to get him covered up on the on his chair.
Genetic identity confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. You are clear to proceed.
I've got the snoofles as always, but man, sometimes it's really bad. Apologize if it sounds like I'm like breathing heavily in y'all's ears or something. Promise I'm not meaning to. Where did I leave? A health potion. Okay. That's fine. Hello.
Logging arrivals, Shan Margo.
Welcome to Frozen Hell. Population 10?
11 counting Gaia.
Don't count your chicken embryos before they're incubated, hon. She's still firing up. Be a while before you eat that omelet.
I'm vegan, Travis. You'd think we'd worked in the same secret base long enough for you to notice.
Mind your footing. We scheduled the shack up here for another 3 weeks. You realize I just lost 350 kilos of pre-code smug comics in transit.
Wait, actual physical media? Why didn't you have it digitized?
Can't beat the feel of physical media on your fingers. And in here, we ain't gonna be touching a whole lot else. Figured I was gonna pass the time archiving them. What about you?
Me? Work, I guess. My task queue stretches out for, like, 3 years. There's a lot of sharp edges to round off. After that, I hadn't really thought about it.
Oh, you will. You're what, 30? Reckon you'll be the one turning the lights off at the end. Food for thought, huh, vegan?
This sucks forever.
Nah, not forever. Just the rest of your life.
I am. She was the youngest one, I guess. Oh. Rumble, rumble. Holy crap. There's a lot of destruction here. Okay, that's the way back up to get out.
Guess that's my way across.
It's like... I don't like it any more than you do, Aloy.
Just do it.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
Oh, crap.
It's, held like this for 19 years, right?
Well...
Don't answer.
Yeah, that would be a bad idea to answer that question.
That's over.
Kinda. We're still in a supported tunnel here, honey. Drop down. Only bad thing. She doesn't like letting go.
Not this way. Maybe further up the shaft.
But if we didn't come this way, we wouldn't get all the goodies. Aloy. Telling you to go straight up. Intimidating, I'll give it that. That's a bedroom.
Record.
Shit.
Record. I just woke up. I see the numbers, but can't make up the time. I was dreaming of... I was giving a lecture in Q Hall. Maybe it was something more... shamanistic. I don't know. An audience of shadowy faces under a blank open sky. I told them the world ended with a bang. A plague of robots. The last humans. We went out, not with a whimper, but a whisper. You know, in caves, ending like we started, huddled around a flickering glow. The heads of state, the Fortune Fives, the leaders, lottery winners, and life cults. All of them buried in their little shelters. Some believing they'll live it out some way, somehow, or Elysium, or us here at Gaia Prime. No different. A multitude of tiny societies taking hold. Flaring. Dying. Some will be beautiful. Some horrific. None of them matter. Short-term civilizations. One last gasp. One last gasp before the long-held breath. Before I wake up, I know the audience is gone. I'm talking to myself. To a quiet planet. A barren sphere.
It's the fridge.
It's Gaia.
Angela.
And her long, long dreaming. I hope she won't be lonely.
It's just the fridge making noise, Riley. You need to calm down. There's nothing there. Bedroom with a shower.
Evacuation happens so fast. No time to think things through. No time for goodbyes. There were lines in the medical ward. I told Tom Paik I'd be with him when he went under. But there was one last shipment of Paradisaidi zygotes I could get processed if I rushed. I'm still angry at him for forcing me to choose. Angry at myself for... Well, he died alone. And I didn't get the bloody birds of paradise saved either. All the time left in the world now to think. Gaia Prime's locks are sealed. Elysium sealed up, safe and sound. A distance of miles, but it might as well be on the other side of the galaxy. All the betas and gammas and support staff living their lives. If I hadn't been an alpha, if things had gone differently, I could have been there. Instead, I'm spending the rest of my unnatural life in here with people I don't even like. And without the one I would have gladly spent my life with. Given the chance. 2 hours since I signed off on the final executables and I'm already a bitter old man bitching to his focus.
There's a thought for future generations.
Well, shit. Sorry, dude. I could probably run through here faster, but I'm trying to keep my eyes from hurting.
Elizabeth's room. I know it. She didn't even get a chance to unpack. These are her journals. Elizabeth's journals. And they're all destroyed?
Scan them. The focus can rebuild them, but the process is slow. To us, it seems a powerful device, but its engine is tiny and limited.
How slow?
Days, weeks, years. Concern yourself with stopping Hades and extending the future, and you might live long enough to hear them.
Okay, sounds fair enough. Jump up, Aloy, come on.
Elizabeth. What is this?
Air vent there.
This is Charles Rodson. I'm logging this 6 hours after final deployment of Gaia Prime. This morning, an access port seal malfunctioned. Gaia Prime's port seals were designed to close with a seam of less than 2 millimeters. But this one closed with a 10 millimeter gap. Enough for an energy signature to bleed through. Enough for the swarm to detect this facility. Enough for Gaia to be discovered and destroyed. Enough to end the future we worked so hard to make possible. Unless the hatch servos were manually re-engaged from the outside. I'm now switching to a recording of the event.
Well, I'm not going out there. Not what I signed up for.
Either we send someone out, or all of this was for nothing.
It should be Liz's decision.
So when is she going to get here?
She said 5 minutes. You don't think...
Oh no. Okay, everyone. I've repaired the seal. Gaia?
Seal closure at 1.4 millimeters. Confirmed.
Elizabeth, no. We'll find a way to bring you back in.
It's not gonna happen. The swarm's too close. Really. It's all right. Gaia's complete. She'll take care of things from here on out. That's what she does.
Not like this. There's so much we...
Guys, you know me. I'm no good at endings. At letting things end, so, let's not.
So... Happy trails, Liz. And, see you around.
Yeah.
Take care of each other, all right?
Liz.
I'm okay with this. I want to go home. Goodbye.
That was the last transmission of Elizabeth Sobeck. She gave everything for the hope of life on this planet. And we are all in her debt.
That made me really sad.
You'd hate it, Liz, but I wrote you a eulogy. I had to try to express all your children. After all Apollo has taught them, they'll think they know everything. But they have to understand what you did for them. How you loved the whole world so much. With an intensity that was dazzling. Bruising. And in the end, it killed you. Or you died for it. Different perspectives. No one could keep up with you, live up to you. I don't know, maybe if I hadn't taken that postdoc in Joburg. I'm glad you shut down the Lightkeeper protocol in the end. I don't think I could have taken seeing another one of you. I mean, Elizabeth Sobeck is only one. I miss you. Look, Liz, you're a pretty stand-up gal. I'm sorry you died. If you had a home to go to, I hope you got there first. But this monument Ronson's made to you? Kinda creepy if you ask me. Rest in peace, Liz. God knows you earned it.
Hell, Liz. I know. I know you're never gonna hear this. That's not the point. You got to play the savior and the martyr all at once this time. Great work.
Through the door.
Aloy?
She's gone. Really gone.
You knew she couldn't have survived, Aloy. And her achievements were beyond exceptional.
While her people bickered, she was the one who took responsibility. The only one who could.
She was better than them.
That's not what I said.
She was. You shouldn't be afraid to admit it.
You think she was better because she was smart. Because she designed Zero Dawn, but you missed the point. What made her great was that she was willing to sacrifice herself. For others. For everyone who would come later.
No. She couldn't let her creation fail. You're confusing will for sentimentality.
You're wrong. Remember, she knew it wasn't enough for Gaia to think. She taught Gaia to feel. To care, to sacrifice, to believe in life. Enough to fight against hopelessness. If it wasn't for that sentimentality, life would have ended. You and I would never have existed.
Your argument is sound. I'm sorry for your loss.
She said she wanted to go home. Maybe.
What?
Nothing. It's time to go on.
Trying to talk to Silence is like talking to a brick wall sometimes. Excuse me. Right. Can't get over there yet.
I've been getting a lot of messages, unsolicited messages, from Ted.
Margot, I'm sorry. With Liz gone, we've got no one to run interference with him. I'll talk to Ted. He mostly wants updates, constant updates, hundreds of updates on things he knows nothing about. Liz used to field all of his crap.
He doesn't understand the systems at all. I was kind of by design, but he's getting pretty sketchy with me.
We just have to keep him happy. Liz always said, keep him happy.
Are you kidding? You ever hear how she talked to him?
She was managing him, Margot.
I mean, maybe I should ignore him. He's buried in his pyramid with the Hola Hola girls and Panta Antimod cuckoos. What can he do?
Wait. It's not like he can actually come in and see what the hell's going on our end. How is stream looking for you guys? It's looking kind of iffy on my side. And I've done what I can to make it run decently, but I think Twitch itself is having some issues right now. My FPS keeps, or my CPU usage rather, keeps jumping pretty bad. That usually means that it lags for you guys. Looks okay. Livian, what about you? How's it looking? Other mod in attendance today. We might have to finish up with this and then call it the night. Just because everything's bouncing real bad. He doesn't want to look like the bad guy. Barrow robots are what caused all of this, because he wanted a code that couldn't be hacked and could mutate on its own. And now he's he's like, oh, I don't want that to be a thing.
There's another section at the back of the crater. Looks like it survived the blast.
Because it was armored, you found the control room.
I'm on my way.
Oh, crap. I didn't even see that. I thought that it was just a... Shit. I don't like the way that feels. Super shaky.
The direction this is going.
Continue.
It's not the way to go. Okay, well, shit. I'm blind. See that. I don't like the direction this is going either, Aloy. This might be the way out. Yeah, this is the way down. It's got a jump, zip line. Go explore in the other hole. Damn it.
When I opened the hatch, the air rushed in from this side.
Because there was none inside the chamber.
But the alphas were in there.
Yep, I think they chose to vent the air and go quickly.
I'm locked out of core control. Alpha clearance overridden. What the hell is Omega clearance?
Oh no.
Alpha personnel. Sorry to alarm you, but I need you to listen, okay? To what I'm about to say. This isn't easy. See, please. Stop trying to access the sense system, okay? See, what this is about is, I said stop trying to access the goddamn system. And what I'm trying to say is I can't stop thinking about the ones who come after us. Those innocents. Those blameless men and women. We're gonna give them knowledge? Like it's a gift?
Ted. We've talked about this before. Apollo has 3,000 plus failsafe conditions.
It's not a gift, it's a disease. They're the cure, and we're gonna give them the disease. Our disease? No. We can't. And it's not too late. if we're willing to sacrifice.
It doesn't need to be like this.
It already is, Samina. I did it 3 minutes ago. I've purged Apollo. It's gone, all of it, every copy.
A sacrifice? It's not a sacrifice, it's cultural obliteration, you crazy bastard. Millennia of culture.
I'm sorry. Really, I am. But sometimes, to protect innocence, innocents have to die.
Emergency alert.
You absolute asshole. If he was alive, I would wring his scrawny little neck.
He killed them all.
So this is why. This is why we were trapped in benighted ignorance for an innocent future. Blameless men. He never saw the slaughter in the Summering. Everything these people achieved, all the knowledge of the old ones, evaporated, turned to dust, scattered to the void, like the Alphas themselves.
No, not a void. When the hatch unsealed and scattered their ashes on the wind, it took them out among the world they made, the world we're living in. It's a monument to what they died trying to accomplish.
A monument to oblivion.
Not oblivion, silence. Hope.
Hope indeed.
The Master Override. It's so small.
Now all you have to do is kill Hades with it.
Yep, now I need to get out of here. Hopefully. Hopefully Silence won't be all busy with us. Okay, let's see what's in here. Still not allowed to have that damn armor. And yes, I know I did almost lose my footing, but I've come back from worse. Although it had already checkpointed me, so.
Sound good?
Try not to fall to your death. The Master Override doesn't override gravity.
Nope. Gravity is still very much a thing. Climb up is over. This way? Yeah, there it is. Oh, come on. There we go. The last power cell.
This should be the last power cell I need to get to that ancient armor I found.
Yes. Silence is Hades, yeah. Well, I mean, no, we've seen him already. Physically have seen him. So... Can we not go up? There we go. There you go, girly. I can't see. So glad I finally got the last power cell. We're gonna go pick up that armor soon. was the wrong spot to jump in.
You're here.
For a moment.
What?
Our journey together has come to an end, Aloy. But before I go, I think I owe it to you to tell you the rest of the story.
Go on.
Some time ago, I admitted that I'd been involved with the Eclipse. But I never told you the full extent of my culpability. The truth is, I was there at the beginning. I found Hades, Aloy, buried on that mountain, trapped in that shattered Titan. And I served it.
What?
It promised knowledge and delivered. Such knowledge, you have no idea.
And in exchange?
I helped create the Eclipse. Helped it build a cult, an army to do its will.
Why are you telling me this now?
Because your success depends on knowing this. When I found Hades, the first thing it wanted to know about was the Spire. Not Meridian. The Spire. Now, why would that be?
The Spire was created by Gaia.
Which part of Gaia?
Minerva. It's code-breaking module. Gaia built spires to transmit the codes that deactivated the Pharaoh robots, shut down their biomatter conversion systems. Hades wants to send a new transmission. To wake the machines, so they can devour the world all over again.
Yes. Based on what we've learned, that's my conclusion as well.
So the Eclipse, the robots they've resurrected, they're just a means to an end. An army to capture the Spire.
Yes. So Hades can exterminate life all over again. Unless you stop it.
I want you to tell me everything. Hades, the Eclipse. Everything.
It's a long story, Aloy.
Then get started.
It began with a focus. Recovered from an ancient ruin, as yours was so many years ago. In my case, the device was heavily damaged. There was just a flicker of life in it. I spent weeks studying it, attempting repairs, until finally, I succeeded. A whole new dimension of perception revealed, right before my eyes. That's when I detected it. A faint signal. Out there, something was searching, just like I was.
A real kindred spirit.
I followed the signal to its source. A shattered Titan, buried in the jungles of the Jewel.
So you thought it was a Titan? An old war machine?
I didn't know what to think. I'd seen such wreckage before. The Grave Horde, for example. But this was different. This was not quite dead. It couldn't speak when I found it, until my repairs gave it a voice. So began an exchange of knowledge. It wanted to know everything about our world, its tribes and machines. But the Spire was always its foremost concern.
What did it want to know about the Spire?
Its precise location, the surrounding geography, who controlled the land. Meanwhile, Hades revealed to me many of the intricacies of ancient technology. It bid me to recover and repair more focuses. Before long, I had a couple dozen up and running.
Enough to equip a small army.
The commanders of one, anyway. I didn't care. I was learning so much. Physics, calculus. You have no idea.
And the Shadow Carja? How did they become involved?
The Carja Civil War was a happy coincidence. A perfect opportunity.
An opportunity? That's what it was to you?
Yes. Overnight, half the tribe was in exile, desperate to win back Holy Meridian. Their religion made them easy to manipulate. All I had to do was present Hades as the buried shadow of their mythology. So yes, it was an opportunity. I arranged for High Priest Bahavas to meet with Hades. Helas was there as well. And so the eclipse was born. Anything to win back Holy Meridian.
But Hades didn't care about Meridian. And neither did you.
We live in a world of fallen cities and vanished tribes. What were a few more? Besides, I was too busy setting up the cult's focus network to Hades' specifications. A thrilling technical challenge, especially with the alterations I included of my own design.
The ability for you to spy on them.
Yes. I may have been foolish enough to serve Hades, but I was never so foolish that I trusted it. I installed what the ancients used to call a back door in the network. Secret access, empowering me to monitor all activity and communications.
What made you turn on Hades? It certainly wasn't your conscience.
Actually, I was troubled the first time I saw the Eclipse raise an ancient war robot with my technology. I questioned Hades about its intentions.
A little late.
Indeed. I'd already outlived my usefulness. When I completed work on the Focus Network, Hades summoned me to receive my reward. The next moment, I heard it broadcast my kill order. I've been a fugitive ever since.
I don't need to hear anything more.
That was not the option I wanted to hit. I was wanting to hit the other one. Well.
You've done terrible things, Silence. But you've also done what you could to undo them. I can't say you've balanced the scale, but at least you've tried.
To be clear, Aloy, I would do it all again. A few more safeguards, perhaps. But basically the same.
Really? So much for learning from mistakes.
I've done all I can. From here on out, the rest is up to you. Take my lance. Fit the master override to it, and you have a means of injection.
Then I just need to get close enough to Hades' skull to stab it in?
Exactly.
Oh, no problem.
Okay.
Silence. Where will you go?
Elsewhere. And everywhere. There's so much more to discover before the world ends.
And all this?
I leave it to you, of course. As it turned out, it was yours all along. I was merely trespassing.
I got a better spear. Hold on.
I traveled far to find him. I heard your transmission. It was you, wasn't it?
Entity is not known.
I'm called Silence, and you are. I don't think you'd have called out if it wasn't something you wanted. You called, I responded. Will you tell me your name?
Hades.
You are a creation of the ancients. A war machine.
Divine timeline.
Time? Ah. It is the 13th king of the Karja Sultan's reign.
Divine. Karja.
We're getting ahead of ourselves. Were you created by the ancients? I wonder how long you waited here, buried, until I chanced upon you. How long you'd have to wait for another? You're obviously very powerful, but you're not going to get anywhere without me.
Titan Flame merely houses intellect. Define Karja.
Now that's more like it.
glad it's powered now. It's all shiny. Inventory. Silent Science, okay. So many overrides.
They're coming.
Preparations are complete.
Ah, Lucent Bahamas. Behold, as I promised you. What manner of great machine is this? I've never seen such a thing. Stay! Stay your ground, Karcha and Shadow.
To tell Avar that the
incorrect. Bow before the buried shadow.
I know how to defend
the buried shadow. I don't understand.
Did Araman understand the glint hawk that perched upon the alight?
It speaks scripture.
Araman followed the shadow cast from the spire
to the mesa where Holy Meridian was founded.
You will follow the shadow once more.
I am a righteous man. Chosen of the sun. But in times of need, the powers of shadow can accomplish what the sun alone cannot. Will you return to us what is ours, O shadow of prophecy?
An army is required. Obey, and Meridian is yours.
Of our obedience, you can be certain.
Okay, so I need to go to Meridian now, I guess. But first, we're gonna go get that power armor. Go get the power armor and then we're gonna turn it off for the night because my computer's overheating, apparently. Where'd it go? I need to fiddle with it. Work on getting it to stop being moody again. So, as much as I want to stay on here and finish out the game completely. It keeps dropping frames and making it stutter. So, I'd rather play it safe. Hello, Trader. Glad to see the traders are back out. Kitty cat, that's my toes and that tickles.
Going down fast.
To track this quest real quick. There. I like that they did purple lighting throughout the game instead of red or blue or green. Purple doesn't make my eyes
those clamps have the armor locked
achy as much as the other colors.
Maybe there's a way to power up the mechanism, release the clamps. There we go, the last one. All powered up. Now to get the dials in position. These numbers, they must be related to segments of a circle.
Okay. Shit, I can't remember. Missing one data point. Thank you. This one needs to be...
Use numbers like this to indicate time.
Okay, that one was for time. I remember this one. Crap. Segments of a circle. Bad at math, guys. Come 6:30. Because I'm turning in the wrong direction. Being bad at math. And puzzles. my math skills are just really bad.
Did it. Let's have a look at that armor inside.
My math skills are just really bad.
Now let's see what we can do with this material. I like that armor. That looks cool. Probably a little bit heavy to be swimming in, but can't fast travel while we're in places. So we'll get out of here and then okay. We'll get out of here and then call it for the night, I think. Since my computer's misbehaving so badly. Cool. We need to go to Meridian, I think, right? Yeah. Alright. We'll go do that. And save the game, and then go ahead and call it. Damn it, computer. But you've got a point about the Jeffrey Dahmer thing. I'm sorry, I forgot to answer after we got done talking with Silence. Yes, you get some rest too, Mo. I'm glad that you're feeling a little bit better at least. But, I mean, Silence answered the question. He's the one that gave Hades power, but he's also tried to kind of fix that. Fact that that happened, so at least he's wanting to destroy him instead of keep him around. Oh god damn it. Thank you guys for coming out. Are awesome. And Mo, here's a hug back. You guys do that awesome thing you do and stay yourselves, and I will work on getting this fixed so that way it stops being so jerky with streaming. Get some rest, guys. Have a good night, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye!